Everybody knows the story of the three little pigs. Or at least they think they do. But I'll let you in on a little secret. Nobody knows the real story. Because nobody ever heard my side of the story. I'm the wolf. Alexander T. Wolf. You can call me Al. I don't know how this big bad wolf thing got started, but it's all wrong. Maybe it's because of a diet. Hey, it's not my fault wolves eat cute little animals like bunnies and sheep and pigs. It's just the way we are. If cheeseburgers were cute, folks would probably think you were big and bad too. But like I was saying, the whole big bad wolf thing is all wrong. The real story is about a sneeze and a cup of sugar. This is the real story. Way back in Once Upon a Time, I was making a birthday cake for my dear old granny. And I had this terrible sneezing cold. And then I ran out of sugar. So I walked down the street to ask my neighbor for a cup of sugar. Now, this neighbor was a pig. And he wasn't too bright, neither. He had his whole house built out of straw. Can you believe it? I mean, who in his right mind builds a house out of straw? So, of course, the minute I knocked on the door, it fell right in. I didn't just want to walk right into someone else's house, so I called out. Hello? Little pig? Little pig, are you in? Are you in here? No answer. I was just about to go home without a cup of sugar for my dear old granny's birthday cake. And that's when my nose started to itch. I felt a sneeze coming on. I huffed, and I snuffed, and I sneezed a great sneeze. And you know what? That whole darn house fell down. And right in the middle of that pile of straw was our first little pig, dead as a doornail. He'd been home the whole time. It seemed like a shame to leave a perfectly good ham dinner just, you know, lying there in the straw. So I ate it up. I ate the pig. Think of it as like a, you know, a big cheeseburger just lying there. I was feeling a little better, but I still didn't have my cup of sugar. So I went to the next neighbor's house. Now this neighbor was the first little pig's brother. He was a little smarter, but not much. He had a house built of sticks. I rang the bell in the stick house. Nobody answered. And then I called. Hey, Mr. Pig! Mr. Pig, are you in? Then he yelled back.
Go away, Wolf! You can't come in! I'm shaving the hairs on my chinny chin chin!
I had just grabbed the doorknob when I felt another sneeze coming on. I huffed. And I snuffed. And I tried to cover my mouth this time. But I sneezed a great sneeze. And you're not gonna believe it. But this guy's house fell down just like his brother's. And when the dust cleared, there was a second little pig dead as a doornail. Wolf's honor. Now, you know food will spoil if you just leave it out in the open. So I did the only thing that was left to do. I had dinner again. You know, think of it as like a second helping. I was getting awfully full. But my cold was feeling a little better. And I still didn't have my cup of sugar for my dear old granny's birthday cake. So I went to the next house. And this guy was the first and second pig's brother. He must have been the brains of the family, because he had built his house out of bricks. I knocked on the brick house. No answer. So I called. Mr. Pig! Hey, Mr. Pig, are you in? Do you know what that rude little porker said to me?
Get out of here, Wolf. Don't bother me again.
Talk about impolite. He probably had a whole sack full of sugar in there. And he wouldn't even give me one little cup of my dear sweet granny's birthday cake. What a pig. I was just about to go home and maybe make a nice birthday card instead of a cake when I felt my cold coming on. I huffed and I snuffed and I sneezed once again. And then the third little pig yelled,
And your old granny can sit on a pin.
Now I'm usually a pretty calm fella. When somebody talks about my granny like that, I go a little crazy. Cops drove up, of course, I was trying to break down the pig's door. And the whole time I was huffing and puffing and sneezing and making a real scene. The rest, as they say, is history. The news reporters found out about the two pigs I had to do. They figured a sick guy going to borrow a cup of sugar didn't sound very exciting. So they jazzed the story up with all that huff and puff and blow your house down. and they made me a big bad wolf. That's it. That's the real story. I was framed. But maybe you could loan me a cup of sugar.